Good morning. Welcome to Our Lady of Africa Parish. My spirit finds joy in God my Savior. Today, we celebrate the solemnity of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin. Mary's entire being found joy in the Lord. She spread that joy to others, even Elizabeth's unborn baby, John, who leapt for joy at the sound of Mary's voice as she carried Jesus in her womb. The Lord in his word commands us to rejoice with Mary as she is honored today. Mary would be the first to proclaim, "Rejoice in the Lord always." I say it again, rejoice. Please stand and greet our celebrant. destined to rule all the nations
with an iron rod. Her child is caught up to God and his throne. The woman herself fled into the desert where she had a place prepared by God. Then I heard a loud voice in heaven say, "Now have salvation and power come, and the kingdom of our God and the authority of his anointed one." The word.
Thank you.
Thank you.
shall all be brought to life, but each one in proper order. Christ, the first fruits. Then, at his coming, those who belong to Christ. Then comes the end. When he hands over the kingdom to his God and Father, when he has destroyed every sovereignty and every authority and power. But he must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. The last enemy to be destroyed is death. For he subjected everything under his feet. The word of the Lord.
Should come to me. For at the moment the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the infant in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed are you who believe that what was spoken to you by the Lord would be fulfilled. And Mary said, my soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God, my Savior, for he has looked upon his lowly servant. From this day, all generations will call me blessed. The mighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm and has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones and has lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy, the promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever. Mary remained with her about 3 months and then returned to her home. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, on this day, we celebrate the Assumption, the heavenly arrival of body and soul of our Blessed Mother in heaven. This was a young teenage Jewish girl that said yes at the beginning, said yes in the middle, and said yes in the end. And God's response was this embrace of love and this lifting up. She lived a life of confusion, bewilderment, that led finally to the foot of the cross, but her yes never wavered. And we celebrate this day God's response to Mary as she models the role of the cross. And so when I was preparing for this homily early in the week, I talked to the Blessed Mother, and I said, you know, I really got a problem. And I know you agree with me. I said, we have the fourth gospel of the five for St. John on this Sunday about the Eucharist. And she said, Trace, go for it. So I am going to preach with the guidance of the Blessed Mother on today's Gospel from St. John. We have been reading for 3 weeks selections from the Gospel of John in the middle of our journey with the Gospel of Mark. So these 5 Sundays are extremely important in understanding our faith and understanding what it means when we say Jesus is the bread of life. And so, for up to this point, every time John uses the bread of life, he is talking about Jesus as the revelation of the wisdom, the love, power, the beauty, the greatness of heaven. Whoever eats this bread will forever have the bread of life, and I will give them my flesh for the life of the world. And then I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day. Well, the crowd said to him, that's a bit too much for me. And Jesus said, no, I'm just pretending. I'm pretending that this bread really is. No, he didn't say I'm pretending. He didn't say it's a symbol. He said, this is my body. When you receive the Eucharist, we don't say, this is something like Jesus. No, this is the body of Christ. This is the blood of Christ. And so when the crowd murmured and as they usually did, whatever he said, he didn't back off. He just kept on coming on to say that I am the bread of life, and you must, he says, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. He's not talking as a scientist or a chemist. He's talking about as a gracious, loving God who has the power to unite with us, to draw us into love, to draw us out of all the burdens and the difficulties of this life, to give us food for the journey. The food of our gracious, loving, crucified, risen Savior, Jesus Christ. And so, when we come to this point, we need to know, and it is so hard for us as Catholics not to get used to it and come up in line and look at who's dressed this way and, oh my gosh, he has a great hat on today. And all the other things that I'm striving. This is our God. This is Jesus Christ. This is the God who knows your way, who knows your problems, who knows your soul at its deepest, most rich and beautiful level, in all its brokenness and all its weakness and all its glory and all its wonder. He knows us, and he accepts us, and he asks us to receive his nourishment and his reaching out to us to touch our heart, to touch our lives, to give us the strength in this crazy world that we live in. You know, we wake up on Sunday morning, we're looking for the time. Not the score of the Sox game. No, how many kids got killed last time?
Oh, yeah.
That's the world we live in.
Yes.
And Jesus is there to nourish us. Jesus is there to call us, to say, I am with you. I am there always. It's always with Jesus. It's always about love. It's not how we feel. It's his love that will let us live the way that Jesus wants us to live. And that is to love our God with our whole heart and our whole mind and our whole soul and our whole being and love our neighbor. We can have beautiful music, and we need beautiful music.
Yes.
We can have community, and we dearly, dearly need community.
Yes.
But in the end, they're all stepping stones to love.
Yes.
They're all stepping stones to walk in the footsteps of Jesus, to understand that call, that he calls us up and says, here I am, the body of Christ.
Yes.
You know, as I think about my story in relation to Our Lady of Africa, I was in Woodlawn for 25 years, and some 10 years after I left, they closed both the schools and both the parishes. I went for 5 years as head of our seminary, then I went to Los Angeles, and I was at St. Raphael's and an African-American and Hispanic parish for 20 years. When we were when I was about to retire at the age of 79, I spent 2 years preparing a young associate to be the pastor. And it broke my heart. 6 months into his pastor, he leaves the Carmelites. And the Carmelites had nobody else to go in that parish. And so we left that parish. I come back to Chicago and we leave St. Thomas, where we were for 20 years after we left the parish as a Moonwalk. So I had a good preparation when I came to Our Lady of Africa for your story. But that all's gone. It's gone. Yesterday's gone. There's no way I can call it back. There's no way I can do it over. And oh God, would I do it over if I had a chance? But no.
Thank you.
Jesus is calling your name. Jesus is reaching out to us. And I think about so many of our brothers and sisters who, for reasons of hurt, alienation, anger, and all kinds of other stuff, just chose not to come to Our Lady of Africa after a lifetime of being Catholic. They're walking away from the Eucharist.
Yes.
They're walking away from this great gift of God. This manifestation of God's love. And we need to start ourselves to appreciate, to celebrate, to embrace this gift of love and this bread that we call and we experience and we live and we receive and we embrace as the body of Christ. He is here. He's in this Eucharist. He's in this music. He's in this community. He is in the Word. He's in the heart of each of us. But He comes again to strengthen us on the journey, to draw us into the mystery of love. So let us pray for ourselves, first of all, that we could be open to this love, that we then could share this love with our brothers and sisters, that we could welcome all and everyone in the richness and the beauty that is our call to walk with Jesus. So I got to do my thing at the end. And that is, my brothers and sisters, gifted as you are, as followers of Jesus, you want to free your heart. You want to let it go and say, I want to walk with Jesus. Yes, Lord. Okay, here's my question. Do you want to walk with Jesus?
Yes!
Teresa's mother was here and visited this parish
about 4 years ago, or four or five, it really doesn't matter, but she loved her experience here, and she was very grateful to be here. She has since died, and Teresa and Greg wanted to give a chalice to the parish in her honor, and they thought it was so appropriate to do it at this time. So we want to receive this chalice from them, and I think Senior Deacon Merv Johnson, are you going to bring it forward now, or they'll come to the back and bring it forward? Yes, okay.
Her mother's name was Princess Caroline Iunime. So this is a beautiful chalice.
Amen.
So we accept this lovingly in memory of her mother. And we will remember your mother every time we use this at church. And it may even be another way of praying for vocations for the church. You know, in many parishes throughout the Archdiocese, they give a chalice or a cross to somebody to take home for the week, and they say a prayer once a day in memory of vocations. And we need vocations to the religious life, to the priesthood, to the Carmelites, to the SVDs. We need vocations to become missionary disciples too. So we accept this lovingly, and God bless you both. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Father, and 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 Father
neighbors, that they may gain a better understanding towards a future life with Christ, that they may use their time on earth to set meaningful examples for those who have lost their way in the hustle and bustle of life's day-to-day struggle.
whom you assumed into heaven. May our hearts aflame with the fire of love constantly long for you. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For today, the Virgin Mother of God was assumed into heaven as the beginning and image of your church's coming to perfection and a sign of sure hope and comfort to your pilgrim people. Rightly, you would not allow her to see the corruption of the tomb, since from her own body she marvelously brought forth your incarnate Son, the author of all life. And so, in the company with the choir of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, knowing that he was about to reconcile all things in himself through his blood that to be shed on the cross, he took the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, and once more giving you thanks, handed the chalice to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, forgiveness of sins. So let us pray then for the coming of the kingdom as Jesus. This is the Lamb of God. This is our risen Savior, Jesus Christ. Happy are we who are called to his supper.
Lord,
physically challenged, we ask you to raise your hand so the hospitality ministers can see you, and Deacon Fogey will come to the back to give communion. Two will be in the front and two will handle the back. One on the side out going back, one on this side out going back. Thank you. So if you need communion to be brought to you, please let us know.
Thank you.
terrible tropical storm about to affect the Florida Keys. And they say if it goes into the Gulf, it could become a major hurricane, which means it could hit the west coast of Florida, Alabama, Mississippi, Louisiana, and Texas. So anyway, just keep those people in prayer. And of course, we know that Afghanistan has fallen to the Taliban this morning. So there's a lot of things to keep in prayer. Hopefully goodness will come of all of these things.
Yes.
The goodness may be in the missionaries helping in Haiti, because they make a difference all the time.
Yes.
So the Spiritans serve there, and so does the Passionists, and we have members of our Haitian community now, but we haven't started working there yet. One of our priests was just there a month ago to interview some candidates for our seminary. So we haven't started a mission in Haiti yet, but I think it's probably going to be next on the list. So. Anyway, just some real quick announcements, and they're very important. If the mission co-op envelope, you can get one in the back if you weren't prepared to give today. Just fill it out, bring it back, and drop it in the next Sunday collection next week. Congratulations to Sarah Stewart, who received her professional pilot's license really recently at the Tuskegee Extension Verbal Conference for sure. Our parish picnic will be on August 29th from 1:30 to 5 p.m. It'll start after the 11:30 mass, so we'll get transportation to the picnic site, which is going to be at the Tolton Heritage Center, which is the former St. Elizabeth site, okay? So we're going to block off the street between Michigan Avenue and Wabash Avenue. The hall is air-conditioned fully, working properly. It can seat 300 people. So we'll have tents on the street. We pray that it's not a 90-degree day plus. Let us pray for that. But if you drive over, Unity Funeral Home parking lot will allow us to use their parking space. So there is kind of plenty. Actually, there's more parking space than what we have here. So that's a long-range issue which we're attempting to deal with. So August 29th, you do not have to bring any food. The Archdiocese really doesn't want us to bring any food to be shared. So we're preparing picnic box lunches for everybody, and we'll have soda and water, okay? If you want to bring some beer or wine, that's okay, but you can't sell it. So that's up to you. So we'll have a group of volunteers protecting, but we need volunteers for setup. We need volunteers for setup, and we have plenty of tables and chairs there. Don't worry about it. We have plenty of stuff for anybody who comes to the picnic. We'll have four 50-50s that day to help raise money for some of the infrastructure challenges that we're having, okay? So they're going along, things are going along fairly well. So finally, there's a t-shirt. You can order your t-shirt with Jackson Lucas in the Narthex, the vestibule of the church. $15 per shirt. They're being printed. The initial order is one in, right? Yeah. We'll have extras that day, but we won't have 100 extra per shirt. So we will have extra that day. So if you want to continue to order your t-shirt, if you can. There'll be some for sale that day, but in the back of the church. The other issue is last
Sunday in the bulletin on my pastor's page. This is a story about the ministry unification team members. And for any of those members who are here that I announce their names, please stand. Cyprian Alaribe, please stay standing. Carolyn Kane, Stephanie Gatto, Miriam Hunter, Liddell Johnson, Jackson Lucas Jr., Lisa Moore, Judith Murray, Teresa Rea, Mario Stewart, Rosemary Sykes, Norman Walton, Lori Walls, Parrish Washington, Lena Young. These are the Ministry Unification Team members representing all five parishes. Each former parish has three members on the Ministry Unification Team. Okay, so this Wednesday at 7 o'clock, all of them will be meeting in the hall here. So, and what we ask is, if you were head of the liturgy committee at, say, St. Anselm's, that you come to that meeting on Wednesday night. If you were president of the parish council at your, whether it was Corpus Christi, St. Anselm's, St. Ambrose, St. Elizabeth, well, Lady Church, we ask you to come. President only if you can't be there, vice president. Okay? So, we don't want the whole parish council. We don't want the whole liturgy committee. We just want the leaders of the various. So, if you were leader of the Commission on Divine Worship at Corpus Christi, you come. If you were the leader of the liturgy committee at St. Ambrose, you come, or St. Anselm, or St. Elizabeth. So only the ministry team leaders, Wednesday night, 7 o'clock, in our hall below the church. And in that letter, which I printed last week on my page, Stephanie Donnell read it, wrote it, and I gave just a little introduction at the top. So please go back and read it from last week's bulletin. There's some from last week available. So I'll send it out by email today to or later tomorrow. So Wednesday at 7 o'clock, it's about the Ministry Unification Team members, all those that are members of the Ministry Unification Team, that's 15 people, plus the ministry leaders that were at, just the leaders of every ministry you get. So Bible study ministry here at Holy Angels, the leader or facilitator of that should be there on Wednesday night. The leader or facilitator of the Blessed Sacrament Society should be there. So the head, hospitality minister, usher, greeter, head should be there. So, Wednesday night at 7 o'clock, right here in the hall below the church. And we'll hear more about that as time goes on. It takes 6 to 8 months to get the Eucharistic ministers together, to get the hospitality ministers together, to get everybody. It's not something where you just flick your fingers. Okay? We have to do it. We're all equals in this. No larger parish has swallowed up a smaller parish. We are all equal that they all may be one. Okay? And that's from the gospel. It's not written by Father Kelly. Okay? It's from the gospel. So. Thank you very much. The weekly announcements are in the bulletin too. Tuesday Bible study from 6 to 7. Thursday Angels on Air prayer time at 8:55 a.m. Thursday weekly food pantry, which is always at the Tolton Center, 4058 South Michigan. And then Friday Bible share from 1 to 2 p.m. So thank you very much. God bless you. Have a safe week.
Let us pray. Having received the sacrament of salvation, we ask you
Amen.